Architecture Codex. If you want to see more, like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe.
Chicago is the home of modern architecture and the skyscraper. So as new skyscrapers have been erected around the world at almost a geometric rate, it is logical that some would pop up in the Windy City. A bunch of them have sprouted along the Chicago River where it meets Lake Michigan. And the tallest of the Lakeshore East development is the St. Regis Tower. At 101 stories, the St. Regis, at one time known as the Wanda Vista Tower, is only the third tallest building behind the Sears Willis Tower and the Trump International Hotel and Tower, as seen in Architecture Codex video number 75. The residential portion opened in 2020 and the hotel portion in 2023. The building is seeking LEED Silver certification. The tower is distinctive primarily because of the undulation of the shafts that comprise the building. Each section is geometrically a frustum, a solid where the shape between two parallel surfaces, let's call them top and bottom, are sloped and create something pyramidal or conic. At first viewing, I was struck by the potential of the tower form being an innovative structural expression. And I saw the towers as apparently combining two skyscraper structural concepts we had seen before in Chicago. One is the bundling of tower tubes, such as at the Sears Willis Tower, designed by SOM with engineer Fazlur Rahman Khan. The bundling of the tubes at different heights was an integral part of the structural design that made it possible for the 110-story tower to capture the title the tallest building in the world from 1973 to 1998. The other tower is the tapered John Hancock building, also by SOM's Khan. It is one big giant frustum whose shape and triangular bracing were also integral to its structural design, allowing it to reach the 100-story apex. And I was looking to see if those two concepts combined together gave us the form at the St. Regis, but I did not see anything like that explicitly expressed in any publication. Perhaps these ideas, the bundling of tubes and the triangulation, being over 50 years old, are just not worth reporting. The structural element that seems to attract the most attention are the stepped columns on the perimeter. They are vertical and offset by 5 inches on each floor instead of being sloped to match the slope of the glass exterior. This is apparently to preserve rentable space. There is also mention of the blow-through floors, but we have seen that elsewhere in New York towers, although it appears this is a first for Chicago. You will also find mention of the 400,000-gallon liquid mass damper on top, but I see nothing about the nested geometries supporting each other. An article about the structure addresses interior reinforcing concrete walls that move through the three towers near the bottom, implying that structurally this is a single building, and the shape is merely an affectation of the skin. The developers will tell you that these sloped windows help increase views, but that's actually just nonsense. Jeanne Gang, the architect of the tower, noted she likes to work with engineers early on projects, as, quote, it gives you more insight. What are the main forces that you are going to have to resist, that you're having to put money into? Knowing that up front is important, end quote. This is admirable in an architect and usually results in better buildings. Structural engineer Dave Ekman had been a classmate of Jeanne Gang at the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign Architecture School. And while I found an article he wrote about the structure of the St. Regis, he did not mention bundling or the triangulation. I reached out to Studio Gang on their Facebook site and asked that question, but I got no response. Big architecture firms tend to ignore my inquiries. They just don't understand the power of the Architecture Codex channel. Jeanne Gang founded Studio Gang in 1997 after working at Ram Koolhaas's firm. This after a distinguished academic record that includes the Harvard Graduate School of Design, an ambassadorial scholarship, and other studies in Zurich and Versailles. Since starting her firm, other accolades have accumulated, including a MacArthur Fellowship, Architect of the Year by Architectural Review magazine, the Louis I. Kahn Award, and more. In addition to her practice, she is also a professor at Harvard and a guest critic elsewhere. Other projects include the Mira in San Francisco, and just down the block from the St. Regis is Studio Gang's Aqua Tower. They also designed the recent Richard Gilder Center for the American Museum of Natural History in New York City. Like James Stewart Polshek's Rose Center for Earth and Space Edition, this design breaks with the traditional architecture of the original museum, with a sculpted form reminiscent of the troglodyte-inspired sets of 1968's The Planet of the Apes. I am not sure if I like it yet. Is it being different just to be different, or is there another genesis for the form? Does it look like this because one display off the lobby is an insectarium, and we are meant to experience the building like we are in some giant termite mound? Still, having seen Planet of the Apes, I was very concerned that some of the displays might feature actual stuffed human beings in the dioramas.
Take your stinking paws off me, you damn dirty ape!
Back to the St. Regis. In spite of its height, it does not loom over Millennium Park just south of it. It is surrounded by too many other towers. But being placed along the Chicago River, the total height of the building can be appreciated from the north and from Lake Michigan. The building faces the upper East Wacker Drive, and that is the glitzy address and the entrance. This is the official face to which the limos, taxis, and Ubers will bring you. The lobby and the common areas are standard upscale interior design and probably had little to do with Studio Gang. But on Lower Wacker Drive, you see the famously gritty Chicago Underground. This is a subterranean world where Chicagoans dwell and dine at places like the Billy Goat Tavern. The St. Regis elegance hovers above this level, sitting on columns, allowing a wide void below for vehicle access, and moving through this caustic void is kind of fun. So even if the wavy shapes of the three towers bundled together is merely a visual affectation and not a structural imperative, it is still an impressive and beautiful different design. But instead of the laws of physics determining the design, instead of a structural expression akin to a Gothic cathedral or a truss dome, we have a shape that's handed off to the structural engineers who are told to make it work. So now I'm trying to figure out where did this inspiration come from. And I'm picturing a caffeine-induced late night at Studio Gang with someone subconsciously stacking all their K-cups.
I love coffee, I love tea, I love the Java Jive and it loves me.
I'm Michael Molinelli, and this is Architecture CodeX.